Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. We'll talk now about the orbitals in the hydrogen molecule, H2. So we'll start with an orbital diagram. And on our left and right, we have our atomic orbitals. And both are going to have one electron. We're talking about the hydrogen atom here. And so we're using the 1s orbital. Those are our atomic orbitals. As they mix together, the two different atomic orbitals from two different atoms, we generate two new orbitals, two new molecular orbitals. Our electrons follow the Aufbau principle. They fall down in energy to the lowest state they can get. So they both fall down to this lower energy molecular orbital. And this is called our bonding orbital, sometimes called our sigma bonding orbital. Up top, we have this antibonding, this high energy orbital, and we'll call this sigma star. It's getting kind of crowded up there. There's sigma star, and sometimes people just write the Greek letter sigma or sigma star. Okay, let's think of how do we represent this pictorially. So over here, under our bonding column, we have a nucleus, and here is our hydrogen atom. We'll call this H1. So over here, this is number one, and this is number two on the right. So now this is the psi for H1. Now this is going to come in close proximity to another atom when they form a bond. That also has a positive mathematical sign. And this is psi 2. So these are both atomic orbitals coming together in proximity, and we are going to mix them. Now when we mix them, we mathematically operate on them, and our mathematical operation is addition. We're going to add them together, and what we're going to get, there are two nuclei. Our new atomic orbital looks something like this. In the middle, we get positive overlap, and so we get more shading in the middle. And this is our new molecular orbital. It's a new psi, a new wave function from psi of 1 plus 2. And this is our sigma bonding orbital. Now, when we discuss this, we also want to talk about what is the shape of that orbital. To do that, we need to talk about psi squared. So here are two nuclei. And if we square this function, we really kind of get something that looks about the same. I don't want to dismiss the importance of psi squared, but it looks a whole lot like psi. And this is our probability function. So this is the shape of our orbital. Now, why is this such a low energy on the left, a low energy orbital? Well, if you look at the shape of our orbital, the shading tells us where the electron is. And the electron is occupying almost exclusively this region between the two nuclei. That's where the electron wants to be. Therefore, it's a low energy bonding orbital. Now, let's go to the antibonding orbital. A little more complex, I think, because our mathematical operation becomes subtraction. Now, how do you subtract an orbital? Well, I tend to think of this as being, let's not subtract an orbital, let's add the negative of our orbital. And I hope that makes more sense. So, here is our positive sign on our psi 1, our atomic orbital. And now we are going to mix this with the negative of psi 2. And to signify it's negative, we simply write it as unshaded. Well, what happens when we mix these now, we get cancellation of this region in between the two nuclei. And so what we actually get is something that looks fairly different. We get a region where there's a positive mathematical sign and a region where there's a negative mathematical sign. That means somewhere in between that needs to have a value of zero, and we call this a node. So this is our new psi. It's 1 minus 2. This is our new molecular orbital. And if you think, what is the shape of this orbital? Again, we need to talk about psi squared. So let's draw out our two nuclei, and we'll simply make all parts of our orbital positive. So that's our psi. Shade that in, that's now positive. Now notice, when we talk about the shape of our orbital, where is our electrons? There's nothing in between. So when we think, where are our electrons? Our electrons are mostly sitting outside this internuclear axis. That's not a very low energy state. That's kind of unstable. Well, that's exactly why on the left-hand side of the screen, we drew psi star as such a high energy state. So we can draw pictorial representations that connect with our orbital diagram on the left. And this is how we treat bonding in molecules.